From Mountain Archer, this is Techno News with Brody Berry and David McCain, live from Mountain Archer's warehouse studio.
Welcome to Techno News. I am your host, David McCain, accompanied with
Brody Berry.
Welcome to week three recap. This was a polarizing week, wouldn't you say, Brody?
Very, very hard week.
Very hard. We saw our highest scores, record scores of all the weeks, as well as our lowest. So you either knew what you were doing or it was working you. Starting off with, want to talk about the high scores. Where is that at?
Austin Elliott right now is in the lead after week three with a 699. So amazing consistency there. Second place, Grant Parkin with a 686. Third place, Gavin Patterson, 675. Little Cinderella story, Troy Christensen with a 672.
All in, I believe, one day, maybe 2 days, actually.
But one or two.
Came in and cranked it out, shooting, what was this, a 247 for week three.
247 week three. That is incredible.
Incredible, so, but still, somebody scored, Grant shot a 251, which is, these are incredible numbers.
Yeah, especially for how tough week three was.
You know what I think it was? It was the access to bullseyes. It was really, you knew where the bullseye was, you were good, but what would happen is, if you were just a little bit off that bullseye, you could still hit the head of an animal, but it would still register as a miss. I had that plenty of times in week three.
And this is a good reminder, if you would like to, you can come and pay to practice your league coming up before you actually want to shoot it for real. So if you want to come by yourself, it'd probably take a half hour, so it's going to be $30. If you're gonna come with multiple people, it's probably gonna be closer to an hour, so it's gonna be 50. But you can come and shoot. Like, this week three has been really tough. We had the Higley family.
Yeah, they were talking to me about it. That was quite impressive. They came and practiced twice, which we don't mind. If you guys wanna come give us money to shoot, that's the point of the Techno Hunt. But they jumped on average about 50 points each from their first practice to their second practice. So they are coming in, I believe, Saturday to shoot their week three. And I'm kind of excited to see what turns out from it.
Yeah, you want to give yourself an edge. Get in here and practice.
So, one other thing. The Jones family, wanted to highlight them. They are probably the loudest, rowdiest group. I mean, possibly rivaled. But,
so much fun.
It's super fun. You can hear them just about anywhere in the shop, so keep it up. But what I'm noticing is it pays to hunt with other, or to compete with other people, because they're shooting the same targets you're shooting.
You can learn from other people's mistakes. So
true.
If they shoot a slide you haven't shot yet and they messed up and you know how to correct it, you can. So there's a strength in numbers.
Absolutely, absolutely. So recommend that if you can get somebody to join. I mean, I just did this last night with Brody when we were shooting. He shot at a target, hit, I can't remember this specifically, but I knew where to shoot because I watched him shoot it prior. But after that, let's cut away to our commercial break.
We'll be back.
Tired, feeling sleepy, weak, can't pull it back.
Do you need to get caught up in techno leagues? Maybe a little extra kick in your step at your 3D shoot, or you're chasing the bowl of your lifetime. Mountain Ops is there to help you get where you need to be. They give all kinds of different flavors and sizes. Come on in and give it a shot.
Welcome back, Mountain Ops. If it's something that I use daily, but if you are struggling to get your full 30 arrows in with Techno Hunt without running out of energy, maybe it is a quick little boost to look into.
And it does not count as a PED or performance enhancing drug. So you'll, if you get tested.
We don't test. You do what you want, honestly.
True.
So one thing we did want to go over is the fact that if you can hit an animal and it still be considered a miss.
So tell me about it. Yes.
We've seen this on crocodiles. We have seen this on elk.
Turkeys.
Yeah. So for an example, if you shoot an elk in the face on Techno Hunt, it counts it as a miss. That is a zero. It doesn't count it as a body hit. That is a full miss. And then on week three, one of the really tough ones has been a crocodile, where if you literally don't hit the quarter in between its eyes, it is a miss. If you are a sliver of the way over onto one eye or the other,
hit its eye itself,
it's a miss. So if you want to bump your points up to a vital, which is 8 points, go for its back.
Take the safe route.
Yeah.
So no more complaining. Yes, you hit the animal, but according to Techno Hunt, you didn't score any points on it. So just wanted to go over that with you guys. One thing we caught up though, or we think, we have a theory, lighted Nox being a potential problem with the Techno Hunt registering. I've seen that with, I've tested it with a couple of families, and it's seeming to be.
Yeah, it definitely is still a theory, but what we've seen is if some people are using lighted Nox and some people are not, it kind of might make things a little weird. We're not for sure yet, but if you can help it, may as well not use lighted Nox.
Pop them out.
They're also another thing to keep in mind. When your arrow bounces off the screen and it's going to bounce back and hit the Nox on the ground, lighted Nox are expensive. You might not want to use them anyway.
You can damage them.
And it can very well affect your score. We're not sure yet, but something to keep in mind.
Yeah, so we're figuring this out as we're going. But that was one thing that we are trying to figure out. We're hot on its tail. Quickly want to talk about the art of ketchup. Not the Heinz 57 sauce, or maybe. But I get asked on social media, we get people coming to the store saying, oh, is it too late to sign up? No.
It is never too late.
It's never too late. We're letting people sign up until week 10 if you want to, for crying out loud. You got to shoot 300 arrows that week, so it's not ideal. But we've had multiple people come in, sign up, shoot 3 weeks in a row. You don't have to do that. They're just barbarians and savages that have that stamina.
Using mountain elves.
Hey, that could be it.
Could be it.
Could be it.
Could be it.
So, it's not too late. So get in, sign up, catch up, and then, I mean, we're not even halfway through this league yet. So you got plenty of time. Come on in.
Come jump in. You could be that Cinderella story that jumps right up to the top.
Literally, we've seen it, I think, three times.
A couple times now. Yeah.
Three or four times.
One quick reminder, week four is African animals. They are some big, big animals, totally different compared to week three. So if you want to start Techno Leagues, come on in. Don't be afraid. But if you haven't shot or you're getting behind, get on in here. Let's get you rolling. Thanks, guys.
Take it easy. I don't know.